So you were what, 5'10" as a junior?
Yeah.
In high school. You go from 5'10" to 6'4".
And the rest is history.
And the rest is, you know, it's pretty good.
But it really helped me though, because if you go back and look at my game, the ball handling skills was probably my best attribute. So playing point guard really helped me when I grew. You know, because when you're 6'4", power forward, you're playing against a bunch of big guys. And let me tell you something, one thing about those big guys, they do not want to move their feet. They want to be in the paint and beat you to death. You get a big guy, you know, you look at a guy, and I compare myself to these guys, you look at a guy like Dirk Nowitzki, who's great, Kevin Durant, it's a matchup nightmare for a big guy trying to guard those guys. And if you see, most of the time, they got little guys guarding those guys. And it doesn't make sense for me to try to post up all these power forwards. I take about 12, 15 feet out there. The advantage switches to me with my ability to handle the ball.
When you got to Auburn, how long was it before you truly realized, every kid has dreams, I want to play in the NBA, I know you're one of those kids. At what point did you really realize, I've got a real future in this game, I can play professionally, mm-hmm. I can make a lot of money? When did that light go on for you?
I think probably at the end of my freshman year, because I led the SEC in rebounding my freshman year, and I was looking at certain things, and I realized if you can get 10 rebounds a night in college or pros, first of all, you're going to be a good player. I never thought about offense. The most points I averaged in college was probably like 13, 14, so I never really worried about scoring. But I was in college for 3 years and led the SEC in rebounding every year, and I knew, I said, I can get 10 rebounds a night against anybody. We'll be right back.